My name is Michael Sheppard, and I'm the director of Big Sky Learning, an organization dedicated to bringing hands-on math and science programs to kids and teens and teaching professionals. A Chladni plate is a vibrating surface that can show us visually the behavior of sound waves in a surface, in a certain shape. Just like when a violin is bowed, its wood vibrates in certain patterns. We can't see those patterns, but with a Chladni plate, it makes those patterns visible, and we can study the resonance of different shapes of different types of materials. Well, the Chladni plate is an excellent way to bridge math and music. Just as fractals were a real endpoint for non-science minds to start appreciating science and mathematics, the Chladni plate creates beautiful patterns. And so to someone that thinks of themselves more as an art mind instead of a science mind, they see these beautiful patterns emerging, they hear a tone, they can understand it. It's a very understandable entry point for people who lack confidence or experience in the sciences. So I decided to build my first Chladni plate after an invitation from the director of the Santa Fe Symphony, who was putting together a celebration to celebrate the 30th anniversary of the Santa Fe Institute and the Santa Fe Symphony. He asked if I'd be willing to make one of these Chladni plates, and I immediately replied, no, I don't have time for this at all. But after talking to him for a few more minutes, I realized this could really be a fun challenge. It could also be something I could use back at our summer STEM program, and so I decided to go for it. Well, to make a Chladni plate, first you need some type of surface that's rigid enough to vibrate. Metal, we tried aluminum, was a little too soft. Steel, heavy, works well if you can vibrate it. We ended up using plexiglass, rigid enough, but able to vibrate. Now, Chladni, who did this original work in the 1800s, built plates of different sizes on stands made of steel, plates made of steel, and then bowed them with an instrument bow, like a violin bow. That set them vibrating to their resonant frequencies. He sprinkled sand on them, and then those frequencies became visible. Ours, we enervate with a speaker. It's really a plate attached to the middle of a speaker, and the speaker's attached to an old amplifier that I found at the dump. And that amplifier is attached to an oscillator, which is a tone generator. It can just generate a sine wave at a certain frequency. And so, set the oscillator to a certain frequency, the amplifier drives the speaker, and the speaker drives the plate, and then by sprinkling sand on the plate, the resonant frequencies become visible.